boogeymen in the closet, monsters under your bed, creepy toys that come to life, gremlins lurking in the dark. These are just a few of the things that went bump in the night in our childhood brains. There's a laundry list of burnt in the brain imagery that probably scarred you for life, and the culprit isn't always some R-rated movie you happened to accidentally glimpse while the adults in the house had their movie night. Sometimes the horrific content was hovering right in front of your face as an allegedly kid-friendly flick. These are some of the great films from our childhood that left a lasting impression by unintentionally scaring our pants off. The 2004 version of Lemony Snicket's A Series of Unfortunate Events centers around the Baudelaire children, the studious 14-year-old Violet, 12-year-old bookworm Klaue, and their spunky baby sister Sunny, who were all recently orphaned.
Children, I'm afraid I must inform you of an extremely unfortunate event.
Yep, the film opens with their parents dying in a house fire. To make matters worse, they're assigned to the custody of a distant relative, the repulsive Count Olaf, a greedy stage actor who wants nothing to do with them. All he cares about is the vast fortune that they will inherit one day, and he'll do anything to snatch it.
I'm going to get you no matter where you go, no matter what you do, I'll find you!
The film has a dark comedy tone that's punctuated by Jim Carrey's memorable performance as Count Olaf, but that doesn't mean that the overall theme isn't scary for kids. The very thought of losing both parents and then ending up in the clutches of a murderous relative makes this a terrifying viewing experience that may really rattle youngsters.
This is an excellent opportunity to walk out of the theater, living room, or airplane where this film is being shown. It's not too late to see a film about a happy little elf.
When you're asked to think of the greatest sword and sandal fantasy movies from your youth, depending on when you were conceived, the first film that likely pops in your head is the 1981 version of Clash of the Titans. The sweeping Greek mythology-fueled epic starred Harry Hamlin as the heroic Perseus, backed by a supporting cast of screen legends such as Maggie Smith as Thetis and Laurence Olivier as Zeus.
Let loose the Kraken!
But what was far more memorable than the film's well-known thespians were the marvelous and dazzling visuals by the legendary stop-motion effects wizard, Ray Harryhausen. As a child seeing Clash of the Titans for the first time, you were probably in awe of its many mythical beasts brought to life by the master who invented and perfected the cherished art form. Who can forget the majestic winged stallion Pegasus, or the quirky mechanical owl Bubo?
He can lead us to the shrine.
But as much as the film likely astounded you with the practical execution of its wondrous, benevolent beasts, it also equally terrified you in spades with its roster of fearsome, villainous creatures. The main baddie is a horned satyr named Calibus. Let's just say he isn't exactly easy on the eyes.
And surely he must be punished. Show me. Help me.
Then there's the creepy eyeless Stygian witches, the two-headed wolf, and the multi-armed leviathan known as the Kraken. While these ferocious movie monsters might have made your younger self flinch and look away from the screen, seeing Medusa on screen for the first time is one of those etched-in-the-brain cinematic moments a child won't be able to forget anytime soon. Harryhausen himself said that her big scene was, quote, a sequence as near perfect as I was ever able to achieve. Well, he achieved scaring the hell out of us, that's for sure. The Witches is a 1990 fantasy film based on the novel of the same name by Roald Dahl. In it, orphaned 8-year-old Luke is living in Norway with his grandmother Helga, an elderly woman haunted by her own childhood experiences with the hags that give the movie its title. As if losing his parents wasn't already enough mental anguish for an 8-year-old to process, Helga warns Luke about the insidious witches that populate their region and teaches him how to spot one. This knowledge comes to Luke's advantage when he spies an entire coven staying at their getaway hotel. Worse, he hides out in the coven's conference room and watches on as the Grand High Witch takes off her disguise. To an adult, this scene is appalling in a comical way, but to a young mind, it's downright traumatic. Thanks to the practical makeup effects provided by Jim Henson Productions, the Grand High Witch is every bit the hideous monster Luke's grandma described in the opening of the film. And all of this happens just 30 minutes in. Trust us when we say things get even scarier as the movie goes on. Sure, Raiders of the Lost Ark defined the action-adventure genre and inspired a generation of kids to get into archaeology. But the PG-rated movie wasn't without its horrific moments. During the film's epic conclusion, if you no doubt remember, people literally melt. But even that was tame compared to what was to come in its sequel, which turned up the scares so much they actually affected the rating system to this day.
Help us!
...1984's Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom is also rated PG, although it famously served as the final straw with the MPAA, who would go on to create a new PG-13 rating not long after the movie's release. If you thought head explosions and gooey face-melting scenes were unsettling when you first saw them, well, Temple of Doom clicked the terror up a few more notches. Set in 1935, a year before the events of Raiders, Indiana Jones finds himself facing off against the ruthless Mola Ram, a high priest who leads a cult of Kali worshippers who offer human sacrifices in an underground temple. Sure, the dinner scene is pretty gross, but it's in the human sacrifice scenes that the movie goes full tilt into disturbing body horror that no doubt traumatized theaters full of preteens. Thanks for watching. Click the links in our video to watch more from Netflix Film Club. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest exclusive videos, plus hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.